Hi, welcome to this video of our series on creating Bluetooth low energy or wireless LAN test with Keysight X8711A using C#. In the previous video, we have learned to create an instrument communication session. And for this video, we are going to look at establishing BLE signaling link, followed with measurement setup and configuration. This began by calling the method BLE initialize and signaling mode PR initiate to set up the tester to the BLE signaling mode. It is then followed with measurement setup and configuration for the RX PR and TX output power test. In this example, we are setting the output power level, number of expected packets to be received, number of permitted fail packets, and the scan delay on the RX PR test. The scan delay is referring to the maximum time duration allocated for the DUT to respond to a scan request sent by the tester. Next, let's have the device discovery process by calling the method getScanInfo. When this method is called, the system scans for advertising packets from the surrounding BLE devices. A list of MAC address, RSSI value and the capability information of the detected device will be returned as result. The DUT scan delay property is referring to the device scanning duration. You could make use of the RSSI filter argument to discard the undesired device during the discovery process. In this example, the RSSI filter is set to -60 dBm. Any detected BLE device with the reported RSSI value below than -60 dBm will be discarded. The MAC address of the desired DUT to be tested will be used in subsequent methods for measurement. Other than this, the system also has the capability to check if the device is able to support active scanning or connection mode, or it might not support either, such as a BLE beacon device. This is done by using the method checkActiveScanSupport or checkConnectRequestSupport and passing in the MAC address of the DUT to be tested. Once we have determined the capability of the DUT, the RX PR test can be executed accordingly. In the receiver PR measurement, the tester is tracking the response message from DUT to the request message sent from the tester. Any missing response message or message which received with errors will be counted as back packet. For DUT that support active scan, call the method acquired. As for DUT that support connection mode, call getConnectedPR method. The result of PR in percentage will be returned and it is then displayed in console. As for TX output power measurement, call the method measure advertising channel power. The system will capture the advertising packet transmitted from the DUT at channel 37, 38, and 39 in one measurement acquisition and measure its average power level. Upon test completion, perform the proper signaling communication and instrument session closure, which is demonstrated in the previous video. Okay, now let's run the program and perform the test. The console message will display the IDN of instrument and device connection, number of devices found, active scan or connect request support of the DUT, and the RX PR and TX output power test result respectively. Well, I hope this is helpful, and in the next episode, we will explore the method to perform wireless LAN packet error rate and TX output power tests. Thank you for watching and for choosing Keysight.